full plan review. What about if you're not offered any of those things, no renewals, rollovers, da da da?
Yep.
And so they said, we're going to plan a meeting. Need to get all your evidence collected, da da da. It's sort of like all bets are off. We're starting from scratch. I will say that from sometimes families feel that way when they get that, when they get that news and they get it booked in. And sometimes, have you noticed this? Sometimes there's not a lot of lead time. They say, let's meet next week. Bring all your evidence, or, you know, we'll plan it and submit it all, email it to me tomorrow, and then we'll meet next week. So first of all, is your reality is your reality. Don't feel too much pressure for that. If you do not have everything prepared and you will not have it prepared for next week, then state that and then push that date out and try to come to some agreement about when that will occur, because it's a thing you have to give your therapist team or anything else that you're going to supply, like quotes or anything, you will need time to do that. But I'll hand over to you. What do we do? How do we approach preparing for a full review?
So a full review, I actually like the wording that you use, treat it as though you're starting from scratch. So what we're seeing again at this point in time is that in that move from reasonable and necessary to the agency now talking about fair and equitable, we are often having to start from scratch. So participants who have come over from old state-based schemes with no real paperwork or no evidence around things. So being able to almost prove all of the things that you're sort of saying. So, and this is where I guess a lot of the work that we do. So people sort of tell us the stories of their lives, but the documentation does not reflect that at all. And if we were the agency, we would build a plan based on the written documentation. So it's not saying that the agency doesn't believe what's happening. It's just that they have a process to follow, and that is around that written evidence from the right people who can say those particular sorts of things. So we also hear, I guess, a lot of times where they talk about, oh, the speech therapist has said that I need 50 hours of occupational therapy. And they kind of can't. The OT has to say what that would be, unless it's been a massive gap in there previously and there hasn't been any funding for, say, OT as part of that. So if you're looking at planning, at having to go for a full plan review, gather what you've got. So even going back in terms of diagnosis and making sure that they're input on the system correctly. So that's another thing that we're seeing, is that where people have come across from an old system to the new one, they don't always have the most up-to-date or accurate information. And the agency has already flagged. So we've understood about typical reference packages in the past, which we've always sort of assumed were based partly on diagnosis. The agency has flagged with their independent assessment style of process that is one of the, so diagnosis is one of the things that we'll get to account in making those 400 profiles that they're discussing at this point in time. So where you've got that evidence, use that. So in terms of diagnosis, and starting from there is always a good thing. The agency will also expect, I guess, things from your therapist, but more in terms of that functional. So we see a lot of reports that are written as, little Johnny did 8 sessions with us and, it all went well. And that's kind of all we see written in the report. So,
and recommendations are to continue to reach goals.
And 30 hours funding for the next one. So with no evidence of what's actually been done, baseline data, new data, sort of things. Yeah. So, and that's what the agency is looking for when it comes to how they plan. So when they talk about fair and equitable, again, it's if you're doing the therapy, are you making gains? Are we expecting that to happen? What are you sort of looking to do towards that? So talking with
it's measurable, isn't it? I'm just listening to you thinking, and I'm thinking, how would families read a draft report and how would they know if it's heading in the right direction? It's got to have measurement in there, doesn't it?
And you've got, there's, so my daughter has significant high physical support needs.
Right.
And if I go, she's now in her early 20s. So, if I go back to those early childhood sort of years, or even those 9, 10 sort of things, we were still doing a lot of therapy. So speech therapy, OT, physio at that point in time. her gross motor skills have not changed since she was very, very young. Mm-hmm. So even though we were doing physio work, there wouldn't be something, I guess, measurable along those sorts of lines. So she's not now suddenly standing, walking, doing any of those things. She's a power chair user.
Okay.
But what a physiotherapist at that point could have done, yeah, we've done this standing and that's working on bone density and hip alignments and mm-hmm. a whole range of different things that actually give those benefits sort of through doing those things. So, again, linking what's happened. So where there's not an obvious, oh, we can now do up buttons. That's a really tricky one. Yep, we've mastered this.
Yep.
We're working towards this and here's the things that we're doing and this is why it's helping us work.
I love that you say that because some of the reality is sometimes these goals are really long term, but the evidence that the therapists professionals need to provide is that incremental progress and step, isn't it, breaking it down into what are we actually working on here and here. It obviously ties into those big goals, doesn't it, those long term, but so many of them aren't achieved in a
funding bucket or sort of thing.
They're not neatly fit. Don't fit into I've never been able to sit my autistic child down and say, you know, we got 30 hours, let's pump it out. Let's see what we can, you know, it's not that approach at all, but we're sort of having to align our evidence and measurement to that place.
And the allied health profit, they have a suite of tools that they can use to do that measurement. Yep. They have ways that they can gather based and information to measure what those improvements are. And that's what we're expecting parents, as participants with plans, and that's the stuff that we need to go into the review.